So as the teams come together after the national anthem, it looks like the power is down a player. They played Townsville last night where they went down 104-68. But one of their imports seems to be on crutches with a moon boot on, so it doesn't look helpful for them tonight.
No, it doesn't. Not sure if she did the injury last night, but obviously they're down that player, which is a bit of a disadvantage for them. Probably good news for the Dolphins, but you know, you never like to have one of your main players out with an injury. So we'll see what happens with Gladstone without her tonight.
So they've had Frost, who's been averaging just over 20 points as well. Excellent free throw shooter. So unfortunately, I don't know many of these Gladstone players yet until they take their shirts off and we see who they are. Hopefully it's not Frost that's sitting on the bench.
No, exactly. Well, we can always, I guess, have a guess, but no, we'll wait till they take their shirts off.
So you mentioned Jade hasn't had her shooting performance up this year, only shooting 25% from three-point land. Normally a lot better three-point shooter than that. Just hasn't had enough game time, you think, or...?
You know, Jade's shooting is her strength. You know, whether she's probably not shooting as much as she could be outside, it just depends on the offense they're running, you know, who they're looking to shoot the ball. I mean, you've got two new imports that have come into the team, and I guess they're going to handle the ball a lot more, and they're, you know, the team expects them to do the scoring. So when that happens, the dynamics of the group changes. You know, Jade then becomes probably more of a rebounder than a shooter. So when she does have that opportunity to shoot it, her percentage, you know, if you're not going to take as many shots, but, you know, Jade, her strength, like I said, is shooting, and, you know, she might come out tonight and be one of the, I guess, main shooters for Dolphins.
Matt and I spoke about it the last time we were here at Early Settler Stadium that, yes, the team dynamics have certainly changed with those different imports, and even Myra Donkin has certainly got a different role this year as well. But also noticed that your daughter sitting on the bench tonight, not suited up. Summer's not playing.
Yeah, unfortunately, Summer's had a niggling injury and a back injury that just, you know, won't go away. So she's had to, I guess, weigh up the options. You know, do you keep wanting to be a part of the team and wanting to play, and make that sacrifice of aggravating the injury more, or do you give it a rest and hopefully you'll be back and, you know, stronger and fitter, pain-free, by giving it a rest for a couple of weeks or 3 weeks. And that's the advice I give any player. You know, if you've got an injury, recovery and rest is the best, you know, solution for that. Yeah.
Because she's certainly had some great impact when she's come in and put some minutes on the floor for Coach Williams, and her rebounding and her tenacity at the ball has been fantastic, and it's certainly going to be missed tonight.
Yeah, I think Summer, when she's out on the court, likes to give 100%. You know, she's always up and down. You know, she's the first one off as soon as there's a rebound. And, you know, she knows she just needs to do what she needs to do when she's given that opportunity. And then look at any time she has on the court as you know, a learning side of things. And appreciating the fact that she's playing with women, you know. So she's done a good job to get to where she is now.
So Coach Williams has gone with his general starting five. Just working out these players from Gladstone. We've got Nanai, and we've got Kelman Poto. We've got Amanda Frost. So that's great to see that she wasn't the one that's sitting on the bench. And we also have Brianna Bailey and Tanea Atkinson. As the Power start off with the first possession. Good inside move there.
Yeah, a great defense by Rachel to put that pressure on number 13. And a beautiful drive from Robin.
Fortunately, that doesn't go down, but Power back with the rebound now.
Yeah, we probably should have taken that ball out. I guess the first few minutes, you know, players are trying to get the nervousness out of their game. So rather than control it, you've got, you know, the...
They've also played last week, so the feel-out time should not probably be as long as what it would normally be in a game. As Kennedy misses that inside pass and it goes out.
That was a great pass from Rach. Unfortunately, Jade wasn't ready for it.
As Frost, their leading scorer, has got the ball now.
Oh.
Shot clock down to five. Frost in the corner, puts up the three-pointer. That's short. Offensive rebound. That misses, and Pryor picks it up. Donkin now on the fast break. Kicks it out. Bryant puts up the three-point shot for the Dolphins. That doesn't drop, and we still haven't had a score. Minute 30 gone in this first quarter.
That shot was fine for India to take. Unfortunately, it didn't go down.
Unlucky bounce there for Pryor, and Powell get the offensive rebound to score the first 2 points.
So it looks like Gladstone's in a zone defence. So that means that Dolphins will have to move the ball around. And then, of course, attack and get into the gaps. That's a great pass from Jade.
Donkin goes down there. Jade gets the ball stripped off Frost. Loses that one as she tries to break through the double. Now Perkins has the ball. She pulls up. That's short. And that's going to be a foul. Rachel Pryor on the rebound.
Yep, that foul was on Atkinson, number 9. It's always going to be aggressive for Rachel inside the post area. Gets a bit physical inside, so.
And I don't think she minds it getting physical.
No,
there.
I know. She actually probably, enjoys it.
As that three goes down from Perkins, Dolphins take the lead.
I guess that's one of Perkins' strengths, is a three-point shot. Oh, unfortunate.
Perkins is being called for the foul.
So Dolphins will probably have to, communicate a bit better on that defensive play just there. You know, that was too wide a gap for the player to just cut through. So right now there is a lot of open gaps defensively for Dolphins. So they're going to have to adjust and make, communicate better with each other on that.
So Nenai makes the first. Ties it up at 3-all, 7:24 to go in the first. And gets the second as well.
So we've got a full court press happening. Yep. And that's the way you beat a full court press, is by passing it up the court rather than dribbling. Excellent.
Great execution that by the Dolphins. An easy two for Rachel under the basket there.
Yeah.
5-4 the lead to the Dolphins.
And that is a mistake that a lot of guards do against a press. You know, if you tend to over dribble, the worst thing you can do against a press is dribble the ball. So that was an excellent execution from the girls. Great rebound by Jade. Oh.
So that pass cut out by Power. Outlet pass and an easy layup. And that was Atkinson, scores another two. So as Coach Williams calls the timeout, just to settle it all down, 6:45 left to go in this first quarter. The Power leading 6-5. So a very quick start from both teams. They were up and down the court. A couple of their first shots didn't go down, but then they seemed to settle down for those some easy buckets after the football press.
That's right. A few wind sprints, like you said, up and down the court at the start. They've relaxed, but unfortunately, I think defensively, the girls need to get back. An unfortunate pass turnover by Mai Donkin. Something that you don't need from a point guard. Like I say to a lot of the players I coach, you've got to value the ball, take care of it. If there's a pass that looks like it's a bit suspect, don't pass it, take care of it, and wait for, make that the safer pass out of that.
So as we said, a very quick start from both teams. First few shots didn't go down. Only two players have scored for the Dolphins, being Pryor and Perkins so far.
It's fairly low scoring at the moment, 5-6 with 4 minutes and 15 seconds gone. Sorry, 3 minutes and 15 seconds gone. So hopefully we'll pick up on the scoring side of things.
So full court press again from the power. Great outlet pass. Finds Perkins. She thinks about the three-point shot. Inside now to Pryor.
Rachel attacks.
That's been called a travel. So with another turnover for the Dolphins, the power bring the ball back down. Atkinson seems to be the one controlling the play for the power at the moment.
Right.
And that's a great drive from Atkinson. Another 2 points to her. 8-5, 6 minutes 16 to go in this first quarter.
Yeah, they've set a great screen on India, and unfortunately isolated number 9, Atkinson.
Is that one great, in and out? Great
rebound from India.
Perkins again shoots the three.
Certainly not the best shot to take. She did have a bit of pressure on her, so maybe that extra pass would have made a big difference.
So as we see Hutchinson and Moat come in for Perkins and Kennedy.
I tell you, I have a lot of time for Elle Hutchinson. She's Hutchins. Certainly a great junior that's come through the ranks through Cairns basketball. A hard worker, you know, very consistent every week.
There's a deep three there put up by Bailey.
And rebound by Naomi Pedro-Mookie.
Great distribution there from the Dolphins as it finds Donkin, who puts up the three. That doesn't go down. And Frost now with the drive. Tries to step around Naomi, but it doesn't quite come off.
No, that was good thinking by Nate to just sort of stand there and straight up. Excellent pass from Rach. Unfortunately, didn't go down.
So 5 points to 8. Power in front. 4.5 to go.
Another great steal from Nay. Nay's pretty good at reading the game. So, you know, just what happened there. She was able to, I guess, intercept, yep.
Unfortunately, it's been called a foul on Nay, though.
Right, I guess it could have gone either way.
They find Bailey in the corner. She puts up the three. Naomi with the rebound. Donkin gets trapped but gets out of it. So Bryant now pulls up.
Yeah, we're going to have to get a few more rebounders in there. And of course stop the break as well.
So that was Frost scoring those easy too. 10 points to 5, the power in front. This time it's Hutchinson. That's short. Donkin from behind the three-point line.
Great pass.
Rachel Pryor for the 2 points there. 7-10, 3:50 to go in this first quarter. So the Dolphins now are looking in a bit of a zone. Now they've changed it back to a man-to-man. As Atkinson puts up that three. Excellent 2 points from Pryor.
Great pass from Nay Mookie to get that pass into her. Obviously, it looked like it was a difficult pass to get through, but it obviously got there in the end. So we've got Nay. Yeah, and Rach did a great job of receiving that pass, you know, and then obviously going up and getting an and one as well. Unfortunately, the shooting is still, I guess, not falling for us.
For the amount of times that Pryor gets to the free throw line, unfortunately, being a 50% free throw shooter, doesn't really help the Dolphins in being able to get those extra bonus points.
No, that's right. You know, your free throws are like money in the bank. You know, that should be something you should at least get 90%, you know. So if you've got a player who's going to the line for pretty much most of her, I guess that's where she does a lot of her scoring as well, you would hope that she'd shoot a better percentage, because it does make a big difference, especially at, you know, at the end of the game where the game is pretty close. So
we've got Phoebe Baker on the floor now, who's giving Donkin a rest.
Yeah, Phoebe is one of our juniors that have come through with the Dolphins since she was under 14s, under 15s. I've had the pleasure of coaching her with under 18s Cairns Dolphin rep. She's obviously behind Myra, having to come on for Myra, and you know, she does what she needs to do. She's still fairly young and still growing within the game. She did have a few years off and then just got back into the back with the Dolphins.
The referees do a bit of the floor wiping. At least they're good for something.
I won't go there. Hey, if we didn't have refs, we wouldn't be able to play. That's how I see it.
They do a great job. I wouldn't do it for quids.
Yeah.
So the Dolphins now with possession, 9-13. 3 minutes to go in this first quarter.
That's better movement. And, oh, great. And that's Elle's shot. You know, Elle needs to keep looking for that shot. She has a great consistent shot from the outside within the perimeter as well. And she's a player that, you know, if someone comes out to her, then she's going to be driving on them as well. So.
And that was a great drive from Frost. Gets it over the top of Naomi. Another dispossession again.
Ooh.
And it's going to be called an unsportsmanlike foul. It's one of those ones that there's nobody in front of the player, so they're going to get that call all the time, aren't they?
Yeah, that's right. I guess with the new ruling, you know, if someone's on their way to the basket. Here we've got
Frost
going to the basket. Yeah. Unfortunately, they seem to be getting clear drives to the basket, so we're going to have to probably pick up on that, you know, whether the player comes across, moves their feet, or the defense has got to come across and help out.
So the first one down for Atkinson. Takes her to 10 points. Power will get the ball back from the halfway.
Okay, so we're in zone because we've got the injection of LJ, number 24.
So Coach Williams has gone to his bench except for Perkins.
Yeah.
Great double team there from Naomi and LJ. As Perkins gets that rebound.
Yeah, Perkins pushing the ball up. Great. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So 14-17. It's only 3 points the difference now. 2 minutes to go in this first quarter.
So I've really got to watch the baseline here, because they've got two players across the baseline, and with LJ in the middle, we'll have to get the players moving out to the shooters on the perimeter, but also watching the baseline that they don't get that pass down there.
So the foul was called on Baker. Obviously before the attempted strip from Hutchinson. Frost with the ball now.
Yeah.
Great inside pass.
You know, unfortunately that should have been probably a bit of communication there as far as who was going to take that player.
Another turnover there for the Dolphins. Atkinson with the ball. Cross to Wilson. That doesn't drop.
We've got Elle on the break. Unfortunate.
The Dolphins just seem to be rushing their shots at the moment. And a great attempted intercept there from LJ.
Yeah, probably wasn't a good shot selection for Hutchins. You know, when you haven't got a rebounder in your team under the basket and you've got the opposition with three rebounders under there, so it probably wasn't the best shot to take.
So timeout to the Power. 5 points the difference, minute 20 to go in this first quarter. What could we say about this first quarter? Is it what we expected?
No, I don't think so. I think what's letting us down is our passing. As far as turnovers go, we've got to take care of the ball, value it more. You know, don't make that pass. It doesn't look like it's going to get there. Find the open player. Lots of ball movement. But I think what's let us down is our shots as well. You know, they're not dropping. So that doesn't mean we stop shooting. We've just got to, you know, keep persevering with the shot. But play the inside and outside game. You know, have your shots outside, not dropping. Let's get it inside to our bigs. If it's not dropping for them, pass it back outside. But you've got to have defense rotating and moving defense all the time. And then you'll eventually get that gap inside. Defensively, like I said, we've got to make sure that we're covering both sides of the baseline, you know, because we've got LJ in the middle, and there's got to be a lot of talk from both the baseline players, but LJ herself, because if you've got a player cutting through, someone's got to take that player and pass them on. You can't just allow them to cut in front of you and not say anything to the next player. Zone defense is pretty much like man-to-man defense, you know, you've got to treat it like that. There has to be a player on every player. You just don't allow them to get that, you know, the lack of pressure.
So Atkinson with the ball now. Nenai drives under the basket, and there's going to be 2 points as the foul's going to be called on L. No, it was actually called on LJ.
Yeah, the zone defense has got to be a bit more aggressive. That was just a bit too soft defensively for her to be able to get through two plays like that. That just should not happen. And, you know, the pass from the top down to the sideline, that should have been a bit more pressure on the person who's passing the ball or the person with the ball.
So Nanai makes the first. It makes it 14-20, just over a minute to go in this first quarter. And makes them both. So the lead out to 7 now for the Power. Dolphins need to try and close that up a bit just before this first quarter finishes.
That's right. So when you're playing, oh, great pass from Al Hutchins. Oh, that's a shame. You know, when you've got a team playing zone defense on you, your best option is to attack it. Attack and then, if you know, look for the gaps. Draw the defense and then pass it back out. And that, you know, that was a great pass in there. Unfortunately, we got to travel with LJ.
They're still in the zone defense. Frost has a
great defense. And again.
Frost again from behind the three-point line. Doesn't drop.
So a great block out by LJ. And once again, a turnover that, you know, we can't afford to do. Great hustle by Jade Kennedy. And that's what you want to see, you know. You want to make sure, well, you want your players to be doing that sort of stuff.
So an excellent couple of defensive plays there. 28 seconds to go in this quarter. Okay. An offensive rebound there from Atkinson for 2.
Yep. Atkinson making an impact inside the rebounding for Gladstone. And a great rebound by Bibby.
Finds L with only 2 seconds left on the clock. Needs to go up. Oh. Doesn't quite happen. That's the end of the first quarter. 14 to our Ken Frost Homes Dolphins and 21 to the Gladstone Power.
Yeah, that was an unfortunate pass, you know, with a couple of seconds to go and Jay Kennedy at the top of the three-point line. I mean, that is her shot. That's one of her strengths. So maybe the option would have been better for her to have taken that three-point shot rather than give it in to LJ.
So Coach Williams would be reasonably happy with that start, but being 7 points down, a little bit of work to do for the Dolphins?
Yeah, I think, you know... maybe the Dolphins thought it was going to be an easy game tonight after winning by 17 points last weekend. not sure if the import that's has got the injury played last week, but you know, certainly you never expect to win a game. You go out every game respecting the other team, knowing that you're going to have to play your best every night, no matter who you're playing, regardless of who you play. So, and that's the way you also approach your trainings. You know, you've got to come and train and make sure you're prepared on the night that you're either playing or training, so you don't have players or your team having that sort of lapse.
So Gladstone certainly turned it around from last week, beaten by the Dolphins by 17 points, but then also beaten convincingly last night by the Townsville ladies, who are just on fire at the moment, 104-68. That was a huge game for Townsville. But their coach has got to be happy with what he's seen so far.
That's right. You know, when you have a big loss of 104-68, you've got nothing to lose the next night. So you're going to come out and you're going to want to beat the team that you're playing against. And yeah, exactly. You just, like I said, you don't expect to win a game, or, you know, you're just going to come out to give you 100%. And yes, we lost last night. That's another game. Let's focus on tonight's game. And I think that's the mentality of Gladstone tonight. You know, we're just going to give it our best. And Dolphins need to change their mindset and go, hey, you know, Gladstone's come out to play tonight, so we've really got to stop doing these turnovers, because they're passes that we don't really need to make. You know, we're allowing ourselves to play like that.
As Donkin nearly lost the ball in the trap there, but gets it to Brian, who scores that too. So the margin's 5 points, 16-21.
So hopefully that might be the shot. Oh, unfortunately. That might be the shot that gets the Dolphins rolling, you know. Bit of confidence with India getting that shot away. And a great pass from Mai once again. But they are putting a bit of pressure on Mai, or on the guards, you know. So we've just got to make sure that we're aggressive with the ball.
So as Nanai makes the next. And she's 6 from 6 from the line tonight so far. So Dolphins passing around now.
So you can see the difference between the Gladstone zone defense and the Dolphins defense. Right now, Gladstone are talking. They're communicating. They're telling the players, you know, the ball's over here, or I've got the ball. And we're not really doing that with the Dolphins right now.
Another almost intercept through their communication as well in that play.
That's right. You can't do those sort of passes, you know. You've got to make sure that the pass is going to be effective.
So 4 seconds on the shot clock. In and out. Perkins puts that one up. That misses. Donkin putting a bit of token pressure on Frost just to try and slow it down a bit.
Great defense by Jade Kennedy. I think that the perimeter play out on the defense against Gladstone needs to put more pressure on them, you know, with the pass going inside. That's just too soft.
Bryant was in two minds about putting up the three. Gets to Kennedy, who misses. Rebound by Pryor, who misses as well.
Yeah, I think Rachel just needs to look at getting the basket in rather than trying to attract the foul or draw the foul.
Great block there from Brian. Powell gets that one back, and it's 25-16, 8 minutes to go in this second quarter.
Right now it looks like Gladstone wants the ball more than our Dolphins, you know, so you just had three of our Dolphins down there.
That's a big call on Pryor. It's a charge.
Yeah, great pass by Jade Kennedy into Rachel. She just had to go straight up rather than, yeah. So, unfortunately, she's pushed with her shoulders and got the charge for it. So good defense by number 13, Hellman Potto.
does. Perkins now picking up Atkinson.
Perkins played great defense up until that last second. You know, I think she'd put the hand in, otherwise it would have been fine. Just in the last second, she stuck her hand in. She stayed with her. And then, yeah, she reached across and unfortunately received a foul.
And also a warning from the referee.
All right, a bit of pressure, and now we've got the ball back.
So Dolphins trailing by 9 with 8 minutes to go. Inside to Kennedy, finds Perkins. Great pass by Pryor, back out to Perkins. Fortunately, that doesn't drop. As Bryant, oh.
Unfortunately, yeah, did not get that rebound. A great shot by Endia, just did not drop for her. Yeah, right now, obviously, our shots aren't dropping, so we've just got to keep putting them up. And finally, just keep persevering with what we're strong with. And Rachel inside just needs to be, you know, smart about the shot she's taken, balance, and then just go straight up rather than into the player.
So now 7-point margin with 7 minutes to go.
Great defense by Jade Kennedy.
Nanai puts that one through. Another 2 points for the power.
Yeah, unfortunately, you can't do anything about that. You know, Rach was in a good position defensively, so that was a great shot by Nanai. We're hesitating, you know. We've had a few options or opportunities to shoot the ball in the last two or three times we've come down the court, and no one wants to take that shot. You know, Jade's strength is her three-point shooting or even around the top of the keyway, and she's given up those shots when she should be taking them. You know, so right now we're really hesitant with our shooting at the moment. Obviously, no one's hot at the moment, but you don't just stop shooting. Great defense by Mai Donkin. Oh. That's just something you don't need. Yes, there's been a few turnovers tonight with the Dolphins, unfortunate turnovers. Great intercept from...
Unfortunately, she stepped out of play there by Perkins when she grabbed that intercept pass.
Right, was that a backcourt or just out of court? So we really need to apply the pressure, as Myra just did.
Both teams are shooting quite poorly. Dolphins shooting at 30%, but the Power's only shooting at 33%.
Yeah, I think a lot of the points at Power's got is from driving, such as this drive that Atkinson did. And we just can't allow that to happen. Someone's got to, you know, stop her, take her right away and force her left.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Kennedy dribbles that one off the end of out of the end of the court, so another turno. And Coach Williams decided he needs to have a talk to the girls and get them to settle down. 18-29, the Power leads with 5:56 to go.
And here we've got Atkinson driving to the basket. Great strong move, you know, it's just slides through. So, like I said, you know, you've got to take her drive away. And obviously, she likes to go right. So, take that away, and hopefully, she'll just pull the ball back out. But we're very complacent defensively, you know, because I don't think we're communicating. If that's what it looks like out there, we look a bit lost. You know, if you're not with the player that you're supposed to pick up, well, that's fine. You've got to communicate and say, I've got this player, let's switch. Or just take the player that's closest to you rather than look for your player.
And that replay showed the first step to get past Bryant was obviously a very good one. But to actually get through two defenders, just slice away through, there was just that wasn't that commitment from those two girls to stop her getting to the rim.
That's right. You know, putting your body on the line takes a lot of courage. So that's something that players need to do. You know, just move your feet across and draw the charge, because you can see she wants to drive to the basket. So hopefully that timeout might change, you know, the direction of where the game's going, because we haven't, the last two possessions we had, we fumbled it, we did a silly turnover that shouldn't have happened, you know, as far as the travel goes. So hopefully the girls will come back in with a different mindset. And we can see we're applying full court pressure. So just that extra, that little bit of,
as we end up with Bryant scoring those 2 points.
Yes. So I'm really not sure what's going on with the girls tonight, because it's like the girls don't want to take responsibility, you know? Like, you've got a great shot, just shoot it. Don't give up that shot. Got a great pass from India to Robin Perkins. Unfortunately, missed that shot. Great rebound by India.
So Perkins pushing it a bit there. Gets to the free throw line, puts up the jumper at the score. 22-29, 5 minutes to go. Yeah.
Well, she had the option of passing it out to either side, either three-point line, and now decided to take that shot down the middle. Great, great shot selection to take. Just had to be aware that we had no rebounders in there, but, you know, it went down, so that was good. India with a steal. So Myra Donkin's gone to the side rather than bringing the ball up. And just not hitting for Robin tonight, for Perkins tonight.
Perkins with only 7 points on 3 of 9 shooting now. So 3 seconds left on the shot clock. Frost with the drive. That doesn't go. She gets her own rebound. Finds Atkinson. Puts up a long two.
So what they did then, what Gladstone did, was they actually drew the players out. So all 5 players from Dolphins were up out of the keyway. Another turnover. Unfortunate turnover from Myra Donkin.
And an easy two for Atkinson.
You just can't afford to do those sort of passes or those turnovers, you know, especially when you're down by 11 points. And once again, another turnover, just not taking care of the ball.
So Frost just throws that one up.
We're really going to have to take care of this ball, you know. Mai, as the point guard, has got to make sure she's got to get those passes, or safe passes into the players, rather than just almost casually passing it. Yep, here we go, forced shot over, and Naomi Mookie getting involved in that rebound. Another turnover. Yeah, so we're going to need a bit of leadership out there with the...
All right.
Yeah. Okay, so what Dolphins need to do now is they've got to come together as a team, have a quick talk in that circle and say, guys, this is what we need to do defensively. More so offensively. Right now, our offense is just not working for us with the turnovers. Yeah, we've got Rachel who's just...
Rattled?
Yeah. Yes, rattled right now. And, you know, that's part of Rachel's game, where she's going to have to, you know, change her approach and realize, you know, it doesn't help the team when you get into that situation. We've got a fast break. Okay, so if you're going to have a full court press, you really need all players up on on their players. Otherwise, it really doesn't help the situation.
So Frost puts up the three again. Doesn't go. It's going to be a Dolphins ball from the baseline. substitutions for Power. Bailey makes her way back onto the court for Jordan Smith.
You know, considering the score, we're only 7 points down, and we're not really playing one of our greatest games. So, you know, as soon as these girls can work together and stop turning the ball over, then we're likely to be up in front. But if we continue to play with the turnovers, we're certainly going to make it hard for ourselves.
So that's 14 turnovers for the Dolphins so far tonight. You would only really want that in a game of basketball, not 2 minutes short of a half.
Yeah, that's right. You know, turnovers can be a bit of a killer. And you know what? Gladstone's, I mean, they are applying pressure, but it's not the type of pressure that forces you to do those turnovers. We're actually forcing those turnovers ourselves. So mentally, we've got to start thinking, you know, let's take care of the ball once again. Why would you make that pass to a player when you've got other players who are in a better position?
So it's a 9-point lead to the Power, just under 2 minutes to go.
So Gladstone's still in their zone defense, and like I said, they're communicating really well and applying that pressure, forcing the turnovers with Dolphins. Dolphins just need to take care of it, and obviously our shots need to go in. You know, I know Robin is a three-point specialist, but after a while, you know, you need to look at your other players in the team as well and maybe give them a go with the shooting. So Gladstone's just moving the ball around. And the difference is there's players cutting through into the gaps, you know, and they're receiving that pass.
As Bailey scores that three for the Power, it's out to a 12-point ball game now. 24-36, minute 25 to go.
So the perimeter players are just standing. They're not really moving. We've great shot by Naomi Mookie. But we really need to get the perimeter players moving around, you know. You've got to keep cutting through and then spot up for, you know, down the baseline at the top. But you can't just stand there after you've made the pass.
So Atkinson driving, finds Frost, who puts up the three.
And that's exactly what you do against his own defense. You drive, you draw the defense, and you pass it to the open player.
So under a minute to go, 13-point lead to the Gladstone Power. Yep. As this time, Pryor gets called for the block on her, so she'll go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, that was a great pass from Naomi Mookie. Seeing Rachel Pryor by herself down on the baseline. And that's exactly where Rachel likes to receive the ball, you know, on the left-hand side baseline. So great pass. At the line, got her first one in. So let's hope she gets the second one in.
So one from two, 27-39 the score. 35 seconds to go in this first half of basketball here from Early Settler Stadium.
So Dolphins will want to make a score in this last 27 seconds and try and get the game as close as possible, you know, the scores as close as possible.
It's a foul called on Bryant, 27-39. He's going to send Atkinson to the line again. He's got 15 points already, Atkinson.
Atkinson has certainly been very aggressive tonight, you know, her drives and just her leadership out on the court. She's making a difference just by being aggressive, and that's what you want your guard to be.
She misses both of those. Now Perkins on the charge. And makes the two.
So now we just need to make a stop, you know, don't allow that pass or the shot to be taken. So lots of communication needs to happen here. So, you know, she can go right or left, but her strength is right. So Bibby was managed to stop her going right.
And that's half time, folks. 29-39. The Power have a 10-point lead.
Obviously, they'll go back into the change rooms and have a chat about, well, I guess, the turnovers didn't help in that half. And like I said, they're unforced errors. You know, very little pressure, and our passes are just really soft passes. You know, it's expecting defense not to intercept it. So we're making the passes. They're a bit too soft for me. You know, if you're going to make a pass, it's got to be firm. You know, and it's got to get to where it's going. The other thing that stood out in that second quarter was the perimeter players just stood in their position after they passed it rather than attack through the gaps, you know, around the keyway and just drawing defense across, because that's exactly what Gladstone's doing. You know, they're driving, they're attacking, they're drawing defense, and then they're passing it to the open player. Yes, we're not making our shots, but that's okay. You still need to keep working on it, you know, move the ball around. But you can't take that first pass, first shot, you know. Keep drawing defense. Get the ball inside, whether it's Rachel or someone in there, and let them go to work. But you can't stand and watch.
So first half is done. 10-point lead to the Power. We'll take a break, and we'll be back at Early Settler Stadium in about 5 minutes or so.
rate, Scott?
Two.
Two. And someone else has got probably three. Is it Myra? I'm not sure.
Welcome back to Early Settler Stadium, everyone, where we have our Kinfrost home Dolphins trailing at halftime at 29-39 with the Gladstone Power. In commentary with me tonight, Jenny Evans. We spoke about it at the end of that second quarter. Taking care of the ball has got to be the biggest thing that the Dolphins have got to change in the second half, already with 14 turnovers for the game.
Yeah, you know, you can't afford to have that many turnovers in a game, you know, let alone five turnovers in a game is a lot as well. So 14 is just, not really the best way to come into the game. But you know what? They've obviously gone into the change rooms, discussed it, take care of the ball. Obviously, better shot selections. We've move the ball around. Let's communicate and hopefully come out in the second half and change the ball game.
So shooting percentage for both teams has been quite low. Both teams only shooting in the low 30%. Nobody really with foul trouble on either team. Couple for Rachel Pryor and a couple for Robin Perkins in that first half. Got to give the coaches some freedom to play all of their starters in the beginning of this third quarter to get the game squared up.
That's right. You know, I think with Dolphins, we're just going to have to move the ball around in offense. Let's give it to a player and see, you know, whether it's the imports, India and Robin. And, you know, if they're going to be hot tonight, let's keep passing the ball to them. But at the same time, let's not forget our local players as well, because they're just as, you know, they've got great strengths with their shooting from outside. And I think that's what's happened tonight. You know, we've got Jade Kennedy and Myra Duncan, who are great three-point shooters, but have been really hesitant with their shooting tonight. So hopefully Coach Kerry Williams has, you know, given them that freedom to say, hey, you girls need to get more involved. You got the shot, take it, because you don't know when that opportunity is going to come again.
So the Dolphins are going to start with possession here in the third quarter, and they, yes, have gone back to their starting five. Same with the Gladstone Power, they've got their same starting five on.
So we've got two on the baseline, yep.
Wright finds a way to the foul line, puts up that 2 points.
And Andy's got a great shot from the top of the keyway. You know, that's been her money bag for the last few weeks, and we've just got to keep feeding it in there to her.
As Atkinson again drives and shoots those two, still a 10-point margin, 31-41, 30 seconds played in this third quarter. Kennedy puts that one up, doesn't drop for her. Quick outlet pass. As the Power puts up the three, doesn't drop. And that's going to be a foul called on Perkins. And that's going to be her third for a push under the basket there in the rebound.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. That's certainly not a foul you want, considering there were two Dolphins players under the basket. And being in Robin's third foul. And once again, you know, there's players cutting through the keyway and no one's there to pick that player up.
So Pryor picked up that rebound as the Power missed. Kennedy finds Duncan behind the three-point line. It puts that one up, doesn't drop. Again, Atkinson has it at the 45. Trying to find a way to drive to the basket again, but
yep. Dolphins is back into a man-to-man.
As the Power lose that one across the baseline, it's going to be Dolphins ball. A bit better pressure there from the Dolphins with that man-to-man then.
That's right. They're playing man-to-man, they're going to have to apply pressure individually on their players. You know, move their feet. if their player drives, you've just got to get your feet in and get in front. Great drive by Rachel Pryor. And she needs to do more of that. You know, that was on the right-hand side, and that's what she's going to have to do.
That's an eight-point margin now to the Power, 33-41. Tick under 8 minutes to go.
You know, that's just basic offense. Set a screen and then the pick and roll. And unfortunately, Dolphins, you know, they've got to communicate. And there we go. Great pass from Atkinson. Just a bit too slow with getting to the ball. So we've got three players around her, and that just can't be happening.
So Kelman Poto at the line, misses the first.
So with Robin with three fouls, I'm surprised she's still on the court. I would have expected Coach Williams to take her off. And we're running a play, which a lot of the action tends to be happening at the top. And a great cut by Jade.
And again, a quick outlet pass, an easy two in the layup as the turnover happens. Coach Williams has seen an early timeout. 7:29 to go in this third quarter, and it's still only an eight-point margin, so it's not as if the game's getting away. It's just that silly turnovers are still happening.
That's right. You know, Jake should have finished that shot off. Receiving a great pass from India, and everyone expecting her to take that shot, so everyone's just stood still. And obviously, you know, went with the turnover. But we had two players at the top, and there's a break. So someone should have been safety for a start. But you can't let that happen where, you know, you've got to get back in defense as soon as that outlet's made.
Sorry, it's a 10-point margin, 7:29, as you can see there. 17 points to Atkinson so far from the Power. And we have Pryor and Perkins both on 11. Brian hasn't had the opportunity tonight Her shots haven't dropped give her the opportunity to score well tonight.
Well, the shots haven't dropped for the entire team, you know. So they've got to go into her more. You know, we're moving the ball around, but we're not really giving it to the right person. So Bryant will need to make the effort to go and receive the ball, and when she does inside, she has got that fantastic, you know, perimeter shot at the top of the keyway. But we also need all our players to crash the boards. We can't just stand and watch, and that's what's happened with this game, both offensively and defensively. A lot of our players are just standing and watching rather than being active.
Bryant puts up another three as two of the Power go for a rebound, and unfortunately for them, it bounces off and it goes out of bounds, so it's going to be a Dolphins ball.
Yeah, the shots just aren't dropping for Pryor.
As that one goes down for Perkins. For Rachel Pryor.
Yeah, I meant Perkins in that last shot.
Frost now explores. Kicks it back out. Yeah. Bailey cuts through. And again, that's a turnover for the Power this time as they mishandle the ball under the basket. 8 points the margin, 35-43, and 6:45 left to go in this third quarter. Still not a lot of movement in the offense here from the Dolphins.
No, it's a lot of just passing around the outside perimeter.
As Perkins this time drives and gets that two. Margin down to six.
So Perkins might have to do that a bit more rather than look at that three that's just not dropping for her, you know. So let's drive and let's pull up for the jumper rather than take the three that's just not dropping at all.
Kelman Poto misses that one. 36-43. This time Kennedy puts the shot up straight away and that drops for her.
That's right. Sorry, she had no, you know, she didn't hesitate with that shot. She just knew she was going to shoot it and looked comfortable and just took the shot without hesitation. And that's what she needs to do. Don't think about it, just do it. So once again, Atkinson drives to the basket. So we've got to work out defensively, you know, does someone come across and take the charge? Or let's apply the pressure on her where she's going to have to cross over and get help defense.
So that foul was called on Bryant.
Yep, and once again, Atkinson driving to the basket and very little help, you know, regardless of whether our arms were straight up, Jade Kennedy made that contact. She's playing fairly aggressive tonight, Atkinson. She certainly came out to play tonight.
Misses the first, but makes the second. 50% from the free throw line for her tonight.
Oh, that was very lucky. That could have almost been a backcourt. You know, it's only 5 points difference. That's really nothing. So we just need to make sure we take care of the ball. Don't get ourselves trapped like what just happened. But I think that's because we're just standing around with the ball.
Pryor makes some heavy work.
Yeah.
And she's been called for a foul here as well.
Yeah, you know, I think with Rach, she's always just got to make sure that she contains her temper. And, you know, a contested rebound there. And then should have just played safe defense, but unfortunately, any sort of physical contact she makes, the refs are always going to go or go against her. Great defense by the Dolphins.
And the fast break this time for Hutchinson. Finds Bryant again at the free throw line. Doesn't drop. LJ can't quite grab that rebound. They find Frost in the corner for three, in and out.
Great rebound by Anzia. And what a beautiful move by Anzia. Unfortunately, didn't drop.
As Atkinson tries to find her fellow player under the basket, he wasn't looking.
No,
and
that's
right. Gone out.
Yeah, you can't make that pass when your player is not aware of where the ball is.
So 4:25 to go. 5 points the margin. Bit of floor wiping happening to get the wet spots cleaned up.
You know, the shots that Andy has been taking have been great shots. You know, unfortunately they haven't dropped for her, but that is where she needs to keep going. If anything, we've got our rebounders down there, so we need LJ. You know, she's got to just make sure she's ready to get that rebound. In this case, where Indy has taken the shot, missed it. And there you go. So, you know, if it comes to a point where Indy is going to be making those shots, then we're going to make sure we've got to look for her every time we come down the court.
So the margin's down to 3 points. As the power put up another three, it doesn't fall for him. And Brian again, coming down the court, finds Hutchinson. She puts up the three, and that was short.
And a great rebound by LJ. And, you know, that was a great shot selection because we had a rebound already. LJ ready down there, and that's a shot that L should take. I think LJ was probably lucky she did not get a charge right there, but, you know, put herself in a great position, got the rebound, and drew the foul. So
LJ goes to the line for her first attempt tonight.
We just have to make sure we don't have any fouls to give. You know, we've got four fouls up there, so we just have to be smart about how we play defensively.
As a second was short, it's 42-44. Power in front by two, 3 minutes 40 to go.
So you can see Cairns Dolphins have picked up their pressure on defense, and a lot of talk happening.
As Smith puts up another 3-point. And Naomi's been called for a push foul underneath the basket on that rebound as well.
Yeah, I guess that was so open that, yeah, I don't think you could get away with having to. So here we go, 3-point shot. And Naomi Mookie unfortunately pushing in the back.
So Nenai at the line for two.
So Gladstone in the bonus. So we're going to have to just make sure we don't give away any more cheap fouls.
One from two there, so 45-42, 3 minutes 27 to go in this third quarter. As Hutchinson finds Donkin, he finds Bryant again.
And that's her shot, exactly, right there.
So it's a one-point ball game, 44-45, 3 minutes to go. So power goes back to Atkinson.
So if we can just keep feeding the ball into India, and hopefully she'll continue her. Yeah. Okay, this will give an opportunity for Cairns Dolphins to be up.
Good offensive rebound there from the Dolphins.
So you want, India's in the keyway wanting the ball, so we're going to have to, you know, make every effort to give it to her because she's feeling it. Oh, unfortunate. Yeah. You know, what do you do? She's been shooting really well, and then you've got LJ posting up there, you know, wanting the ball. So, unfortunately, the shot didn't go in.
So, 2:26 to go. The Power's called a timeout here. Getting a little bit close for them from the coach's point of view.
Well, Dolphins have done a great job getting back into the game, you know. They've stopped doing the turnovers, you know, not as much as what they were doing in the first half, so that's got to make a difference. The shots, some of the shots are now dropping, and, you know, that's credit to India. And we've got to make sure that we keep going to her. But I'd like to see Myra Donkin putting up some threes. You know, she's really not playing her natural game tonight. She's sort of looking and looking at other options for other players rather than her own game. So I'd love to see Myra, you know, take charge and start, you know, taking the opportunity when she's got it.
Mentioned it during the call as well. The defensive intensity is certainly picked up from the Dolphins' point of view, and they're all over the Power at the moment.
That's right, you know. And sometimes your defensive pressure only has to be notched up, 20%, and that's all it takes for players. You know, a lot of players don't like pressure. So as soon as you put that tiny little bit of pressure, players tend to, you know, get frustrated and they make those passes that they shouldn't be, which is what Gladstone was doing to Cairns. So now we need to reverse that and, you know, apply that pressure back on Gladstone as well. And it's good to see that you know, we're getting turnovers from it. But I think even when you're aggressive on defense, then you become aggressive on offense and offense starts to happen for you. But if you're going to be timid and you know, just expect things to happen, it's not going to happen.
So coming out of the timeout, the Dolphins had a full court press, which nearly resulted in a turnover. As they do get a turnover now, as an offensive foul is called on an illegal screen.
Yeah, well, you've got Robin on Atkinson, you know. Atkinson, yes, pushing her to one side. So, you know, great work from the Dolphins to get that ball back. And fantastic move by LJ.
So as the Dolphins take the lead, 46-45. 2 minutes to go in this third quarter. Frost probing and turnover as she tries to find Nanai, and its pass goes astray.
You know, LJ would have to be the tallest player out there right now. So we've got to take advantage of that. You know, look at your outside game, but then move the ball around and get it inside right there. She's open, but that was just a bit too late. You know, sometimes that extra dribble, you just can't afford to do that. You've got to get the ball in as soon as you can.
So find Atkinson again out on the wing. 8 seconds left. She's pulling Brian out.
Yeah, you know, she didn't need to get that foul because that was way out past the three-point line. So, you know, maybe put that pressure on when you're getting closer to the three, but not so far out.
And as you said, in the bonus, so they're going to go straight to the free throw. That's her third foul as well. Yeah. She's going to take a seat now as Dolphin comes in for her.
So now that Indy's gone off, obviously we've got to look at other options offensively. So, you know, you've got three great three-point shooters out there. So move the ball around, attack, and then look to get it back out to our three-point shooters.
So Atkinson misses the first. Gets the second, takes her to 19 points, still shooting 50% from the free throw line. This time it's Perkins that pulls up from the free throw line, gets that to drop. Still the Dolphins lead.
Now we've got to make sure we don't do some silly cheap fouls, you know, with the pressure we're putting on. There's no need to be sending them to the free throw line. So we've got to be smart in this last minute.
Frost left wide open for that three, and that goes down.
And I think that was a lack of talk between the two players at the top. The other one expected the other player to get it. So a bit more communication there.
So the power again takes the lead, 49-48 with 40 seconds to go. As Duncan puts up a three, as you've been asking for, and that goes down.
That's right, and that's what Myra needs to do, you know. She's got an open shot, take it.
So it's 51-49 lead to the Dolphins. 25 seconds as Atkinson drives again, misses that one. Kennedy pulls up.
And you know, Myra seems to have this knack of shooting these three-point shots when we need them, you know, in the close situations.
So Hutchinson puts up a three, 4 seconds to go. Atkinson puts up the final shot and that goes down. It's tied up, 51 apiece. As the end of the third quarter.
Look, I know there's a bit of pressure on players when it's, you know, going down to 10 seconds, 8 seconds, but, you know, if a player just shot a three, I think I'd be looking to give the ball back to that player who just shot that three. That's how I would play, you know, and that's something that a lot of players don't seem to, are not aware of. If you've got a player who's hot or just made the last two shots, let's go back to that player. Let's not go away from them.
Go back to the oil well, as they say. So, as we said, Dolphins certainly picked up their intensity on the defensive end. A couple of shots dropped for them. Got the game back under 10 points. And all of a sudden, it's tied up here with 3 points. At the end of the third quarter. If we keep up that intensity, the game's got to be for the Dolphins.
Yeah, I really believe that if Dolphins can limit their turnovers, obviously the shots need to go down. But it's more so the turnovers. If we can take care of the ball, apply the pressure that we did in the third quarter, then we should come away with a win. But, you know, you don't just come out and go, oh, it's 51 all. You know, we're back in the game. You still got to apply the pressure. You still got to make sure you're moving the ball. You're moving, you know, working hard defensively. Always look for a stop, you know, force a turnover. And just be in the player's face. You know, and it's got to happen as a team. You can't just have one or two players come out and apply that pressure. It's got to be an overall team effort.
So the Dolphins outscored the Power 22-12 in that third quarter. But we still said during that quarter there was times where their offense was stagnant.
Yeah, that's right. Look, you know, coaches have their certain plays that they want the players to get through. So, you know, when your shots aren't dropping, you're going to try a different direction. And so players, you know, come out and then they might have to pass the ball to certain players, and so you tend to stop. You stop playing, and because everyone's waiting for the next person to make that pass or, you know, cut through here. And, you know, the best offense against a zone defense is attack. So if you're dribbling the ball at the top or on the side and you're not looking at the basket, well, it's going to be very difficult, and you're going to probably end up using the 24-second violation clock.
So game on here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
As Duncan is putting some pressure on Frost. Unlucky there for the Dolphins. It's Atkinson throws the ball back, and it comes off Perkins and goes out of bounds.
Yeah, it was. You know, we know who the three-point shooter is, a 21. So we've got to make sure we don't leave her alone. So Dolphins on a break. So as you can see, we've got the double screen on both sides of India, of Robin. And a great steal from Robin.
Pass wasn't quite on there to LJ in the center. She had three converging on her.
Yeah, you know, you can't pass it to a player who's got three players, but if you're going to pass the ball into LJ, you can't pass it to her feet. You can't pass it to her waist. You need to get the ball up in the air where she can, you know, grab it. A lot of times when LJ's inside it, a lot of the players tend to pass it at her feet. She will not get it if it's at her feet. They need to give it to her in the air. She's more effective with her, you know, she can suck that ball in and then go to work rather than trying to bend down to get the ball.
So Perkins put that one up, a three-point shot, short.
So it's probably a good time for the coach to have a timeout, you know, because it's certainly looking a bit scrappy right now.
So Sapau take the lead back, 53-51. 8 minutes 25 to go. Perkins puts up another shot. Those two got for her, so back to being all level, 53 apiece. As we see Indy O'Brien, the score has been shredded to check back in. Yeah. Perkins drives again. Sorry, Atkinson drives again.
So. Take the shot. Yeah.
Great three-point shot.
Yeah, that was a much better shot selection. You know, defense hadn't applied any pressure on Robin at all, so that was a great shot to take.
The referee just having a chat to a couple of the players, trying to get them to settle down a bit underneath the basket.
Well, you know, right now, if Dolphins can take care of the ball, and here we've got Robin just pulling up, you know, the defense doesn't come out too hard, we'll take the shot. You know, next time defense might come out, and that's when you drive and do your jumper, or you drive and dish it off.
So Bryant's joined the court again. Duncan certainly put a body on the line there.
Oh no, that's India's fourth foul.
It is.
You know, I figure we're playing full court. Man to man, yeah, that, you know, if we're going to do that, we really need to be careful with our fouls. Unfortunate foul by India.
She has to take a seat now with those four fouls. Dolphins in the lead though, 56-53 with 7:40 to go.
Nene at the line. Gets her first one in. Really? You know, it's what you tell your juniors, box out, block out. You know, you just never allow someone to just go for the boards in a free throw situation.
As Gladstone this time is putting the pressure on. Perkins puts up for another three. That one doesn't
drop. Rebound by Jade. So we're standing around again, you know. We're just...
So that was a foul on Wilson for the power.
So defensively, Gladstone's really clogging that inside.
This time Jade puts up the three. Nothing but net.
That's right, yeah. And that's her shot. So great shot by Jade Kennedy, and she's going to keep looking for it.
So the Dolphins out to a five-point lead now, 59-54, 7 minutes to go.
And, you know, you find a player like Jade, as soon as she hits one shot, then she's going to be on for the next few shots. So I'd be looking to get the ball to her. This is where our defense needs to really pick up, communicate with each other. And
as Wilson puts up a shot right at the end of the shot clock.
So we need to get our runners down. Great movement of the ball, and come up with a basket.
So Pryor puts those two in, and Power has called for a timeout. Coach is not happy. 61-54, 6 minutes 30 to go. So the Power played last night. Is a little bit of road tiredness starting to set into their game?
Well, I guess, and here we've got the pass from Elle Hutchins over to Myra Donkin. And then a great pass from Myra into Rachel Pryor, balancing herself up and getting that shot in, you know, rather than trying to push into the play. She's just gone straight up. So great, great play, offensive play by the Dolphins. Yeah, you know what? I think, like you said, they've probably got tired legs from last night's game. They're still being aggressive, you know. They're still in this game. Not Atkinson, number nine Atkinson, has probably slowed down a bit. And she was probably the difference in the first half between the two teams. Maybe Dolphins have adjusted to, defensively to stop her from... she hasn't taken as many drives as she had in the first half.
Now, her scoring has certainly dried up in this second half. She was 16 points at halftime, but she's sitting on 21 now. So the Dolphins have done a great job to obviously stop that drive and clog up that lane for her.
That's right. The defense has made a difference with limiting his scoring. She's still certainly attacking, but I think defensively, Dolphins have made a great job, done a great job here. So we've picked up our players full court. So it's important for Dolphins to really talk.
The Power have a turnover here. Great. Hutchinson drives all the way. As Perkins puts that one back up, it gets fouled. She'll go to the line for two. 61-54, Dolphins lead by seven. With 6 minutes and 7 seconds to go. We'll see.
Yeah, great attacking by Hutchins, and you know, for Robin to follow up. So great to see that she was trailing for that rebound and obviously drawing a foul.
Perkins an 80% free throw shooter on the season. Misses the first.
Certainly not been the greatest night for Robin Perkins on the line tonight. So we're applying full court pressure. And that's exactly what you want from full court pressure. We just have to make sure we get back pretty quick.
So Gladstone certainly trying to catch up with the turnovers. They're up to 17 now, and the Dolphins still on 18 after having 14 in that first half.
And once again, an unforced turnover, but fortunately for Cairns, we get the ball back.
5 seconds on the shot clock, though.
But, you know, like I said, the perimeter players are just standing there. So Myra's driven, and the only player that's moved is Rachel. So the rest of the others have got to move to a position where she can get the ball to them. So 3 seconds. Oh. So we've got runners 21 down the court.
So that was Bailey that gets the 3 points there for Gladstone.
Yeah, we really can't afford to just allow players to get the ball and not have any pressure on. So Cairns will have to get back. Cairns Dolphins will have to get back as quick as they can.
As Rachel drives to the basket there, that doesn't drop. Atkinson now with the outlet pass to Frost. Easy two, and Coach Williams says, no, let's have a chat, ladies, and he's called for a timeout. 62-59, the Dolphins still in front. 5 minutes to go in this final quarter.
Once again, we've allowed a few turnovers to set in, so, you know, we're going to have to make sure. And here we go with Atkins. Yep, great fast break by
Frost
coming down the court. And that's something that the safety's got to realise. You just can't allow a player to get down there and have an uncontested shot.
So just those last couple of plays, a couple of turnovers from the Dolphins, tighten the game back up. 11 points to 8 in this final quarter now.
I guess as a coach, you know, what do you say? Girls, stop your turnovers. Let's value the ball. Let's take care of it. You can only say so much and rely and hope that the players are going to do just that. Because it's just going to, that is the difference in the game right now, is the turnovers. Because you're applying the defensive pressure. We're doing okay offensively. But if you're going to give the opposition, you know, the ball back, well, it's going to be really difficult getting it, you know, going forward in the game. You're just going to be in a fighting battle trying to get, you know, one step forward, two steps back kind of thing. So take care of the ball, really.
So our offense certainly changed when Bryant went off the court with the fourth foul. She's back on the court now. 5 minutes to go. She's going to have to play smart to get through the end of the game.
That's exactly right, and I'm sure she will. We just need to make sure that we take, you know, advantage of Bryant being on the court. And great drive by Naomi Mookie. You know, sometimes teams leave players thinking they're not going to do much, but that player comes out and could be the difference in the game sometimes. Unfortunately, a basket by Gladstone puts them straight back into the game again. Great pass from Naomi Mookie.
Finds Bryant under the basket, 66-61. 4 minutes 13 to go in this final quarter. Dolphins just with their noses in front.
Dad.
Turnover there from the Power, so the Dolphins get the ball back. Chance to extend this lead.
You know, the difference, the pressure on defense has certainly picked up, but I think Gladstone's also showing that they're getting tired, you know, so Cairns Dolphins got to take advantage of them. They look exhausted right now.
So as Perkins takes that shot, she's fouled by Atkinson, and it's going to send Perkins to the line now.
Yeah, great shot by Robin Perkins, and to draw that foul as well. And once again, just needs the shots to drop. Free throws are so important.
The Dolphins have certainly missed a few free throws tonight. Could have had a much bigger lead. As Frost finds her way to the basket, 63-66, 3 minutes 40 to go in this game.
Yeah, there just seems to be too much space allowed with Gladstone's offense. You know, they're able to get those easy shots and the drives to the basket without too much pressure on them. So Dolphins are going to have to really work on that. And unfortunately, not dropping the shots, not dropping as well.
So it's a 3-point game. Atkinson with the ball for Power.
So it looks like Gladstone are playing the same offense that Dolphins does in a zone defense, or zone offense in this case. The double screen on either side. Yep, we've got screens on either side. And then, of course, Atkinson driving to the basket, certainly making, you know, the difference in the game.
Five seconds on the shot clock. They find Atkinson at the free throw line, who puts up the shot. Doesn't drop. As Duncan gets a great rebound.
So we really need to execute our offense, you know, take care of the ball. Let's use it. And great move by Naomi Mookie. She's certainly come out in the fourth quarter, ready to play. Made a big difference. Now, 21s, you know, she's shot all their three-pointers tonight, so they've got to apply more pressure. Robin's got to get up in her face and not allow her that easy shot. That was just too easy.
So that's 17 points now for Frost. It's a 68-66 game. As Pryor puts that two down, and she'll go to the free throw line for the and one. The old-fashioned three-point play.
Yeah, that was a great cut by Rach to receive the ball from Robin. You know, if when you've got a player who drives to the basket, you know, they're always going to be looking for someone cutting through. So offensively, if you see that happening, go into the gaps and, you know, expect that pass. And in this case, Rachel Pryor did and got rewarded with the end one.
So coach has just taken Perkins to the bench to give her a short break, I'm assuming, before the end of the game. Puts Hutchinson on to give her that break. 2 minutes and nine to go. It's a four-point game.
Yeah, you know, I don't think they really lose anything with Elle Hutchins coming on the court. She's always consistent. She works really hard defensively, and she's a great offensive player, you know, and she's come out in games where she's just made a big difference in attacking. So, you know, she's really matured in her game. So hopefully that decision of taking Robin off the court will be an advantage for Dolphins. So as you can see, Elle's been placed on Atkinson, and Elle is one of our best defensive players, bar Myra Duncan. And that's what you want.
As another turnover by Duncan.
Yeah, unfortunately, she expected Andia to receive that pass.
So 68-71, a minute 44 to go. Dolphins with that three-point lead. Need to protect the ball.
That's right. We had, you know, a bit of space to have a bit of a breather, but unfortunately that's not going to happen now. Great pass from Naomi Mookie. Oh, that's unfortunate.
Has that foul's call been called on Naomi? Let's have a look at the replay here.
I think the coach will, Kerry Williams, will have to be careful. He's already received a few fouls, tech fouls. Yeah, unfortunately, Kerry Williams, the coach, has received a few tech fouls in other games where he has been thrown out of the stadium. So
it certainly gets very passionate about the game.
That's
and
right.
Has been warned to settle it down a bit. So we've got a minute 22 to go. Yeah, Dolphins with that three-point lead.
Just needs to contain his frustration. Okay, so we've got Elle playing on Atkinson, you know, Elle being one of the better defenders in with the Dolphins. But right now, Atkinson, being a more experienced player, has, you know, gone, okay, I've got a shorter player on me, I'm stronger than this player, so I'm going to post her up. And that's exactly what she did. So Dolphins have got to have to be aware of that and look to help out on that.
She makes the first, 69-71. It's a one-point ball game as she makes the second.
So full court pressure on the Dolphins.
Bryant puts up the two. That's short.
Right, we've got to make sure that we don't give a foul away because both teams are in the bonus. Four fouls to Dolphins and five to Gladstone. And there you go. Got to keep the pressure up, yeah.
So timeout has been called by the Dolphins. 35 seconds to go. The Power have got a one-point lead. So Coach Williams will have to draw something up that's going to make a score.
Yeah, well, we're gonna have to. Here we go. And, you know, you've got Atkinson. All night she's been taking this drive, and it's been working for her. So that's been the difference with Atkinson, just being aggressive in offense. Unfortunately, you know, she was there was a mismatch there. But they're going to have to apply more pressure or have someone on Atkinson and just take her away from the game. Otherwise, that's their go-to player right now is Atkinson.
So with 34 seconds left in the game, Gladstone's going to get a possession back after whatever Coach Williams draws up for the Dolphins here in this timeout. It's got to be good to make the score, and is it going to be one of those games?
Well, you would hope that, you know, the girls come out in this last 34 seconds, and rather than be hesitant, just you know, if the shot's there, take it. If the play's out on you and there's a gap, drive to the basket. But everyone's got to be in there to rebound, you know, so we have that second opportunity offensively. So really important that if the shot goes up, let's get in there for the offensive rebound to give ourselves another chance of getting the last shot of the game rather than give Gladstone that. Very important basket coming up. And once again, really need to take care of that ball.
The Dolphins struggling to get the ball in here. They find Perkins,
and
he scores. 31 seconds to go. The Dolphins take the lead.
Yeah, sometimes the unexpected happens. You know, you plan all this and that. And great steal by India.
And that's another 2 points. And that's time for the Power to have a timeout and have a chat about their last play now. As the Dolphins lead 75-72, under 20 seconds to go. The Ken Frost Homes Dolphins have just come to play in that straight out after that timeout.
You know, I love these sort of games where it's always so close, especially when you're at home, because it gets the crowd involved and the atmosphere picks up, and that's what the crowd wants to watch, you know, a nice close game. And obviously if your home team comes out with a win, then everyone's excited and pumped. But, you know, in this last 19 seconds, yep, great drive by, great pass for a start. And then Dolphins applying a bit of pressure, just a little. And forcing the, yep, and India just making that beautiful steal. And then finishing it off.
Just great hands poking the ball away there. And it's now going to be up to the Power to come up with their play of either trying to tie the game up or going for 2-for-1 so they can actually get the ball back and to get the win.
Well, you know, they've probably got a couple of options here. You've got Atkinson, number 9, who's been, you know, pretty strong for them tonight. So the ball could go to her, or it could go to 21, who's been shooting the threes tonight. So Dolphins really have to be aware of those two players, but at the same time, they've got to make sure that the other players aren't going through and receiving the pass, you know, because they've also been attacking through the middle where the open gaps are. So really important possession here.
So Atkinson inbounds the ball, finds a way under the basket to make the two. Only a couple of seconds taken off the clock.
Yeah.
So foul's called on Frost. Donkin's going to walk to the other end of the court to shoot the two free throws.
Yeah, you know, that pass to Atkinson, you know, you knew that was going to go to well. So That would have been what the coach wanted. Let's get the ball to our best player on the court, Atkinson. Great screen. Almost was a turnover, but was strong enough to put the shot back up.
So two pressure free throws for Donkin. Makes the first. Takes the lead out to 2 points, 76-74.
And these are the sort of shots that you train for, you know, all those days of or nights of just shooting up free throws. And Murray does a fantastic job in nailing both those free throws.
So 77-74.
We just need to make sure that we don't foul, give a foul away, or allow them a three-point shot.
As the free goes up, that's short. Ryan has the rebound. And folks, that's the game. The Dolphins, Ken Frost Homes Dolphins, 77-74. What a great win by the Dolphins tonight. A hard game, well fought out, and execution at the end just got them across the line.
Well, that's right. The Dolphins really had to work to come out with a win tonight. You know, credit to Gladstone. They came out and they wanted to win this game. And, we took it lightly at the start, but obviously we picked up our defense and applied a bit more pressure. We didn't have the best shooting game, but, our shooting with our drives fell for us. Andy came out and shot a few shots at the top of the keyway, and that got us back in the game. We took care of the ball in the second half, but still probably not, a great percentage as far as turnovers go. But a win's a win. So, credit to Dolphins for coming out with that win in the end.
So Perkins top scored for the Dolphins, 23 points. Pryor did well with 18. And she's very efficient with 8 from 12 to score those 18 points. While obviously Atkinson was top scorer for the power, and Frost shooting all those threes towards the end there, did a great job to get 17 points. Both of those players didn't get a break. Played last night as well, so great effort by the Gladstone power.
That's right, great effort by Gladstone. And, Dolphins coming out and finishing on top. So, a win's a win. So, you know, it feels good to have, for the Dolphins anyway, to come out with that win.
So thank you, Jenny Evans, for joining me tonight in commentary. Excellent job.
My pleasure, Gavin. First time ever.
As you said, a win for our Ken Frost home Dolphins here at Early Settlers Stadium. We'll be back shortly, folks, with the men's game, the Marlins taking on the Gladstone Power as well. We'll see you in about 20 minutes.